If you look at any newspaper article today reporting on solar energy, you'll often read this term, which is dollar per watt. Or if it's a good journal or if it's a good technical publication which knows a little bit about solar, so you'll see this term quoted as dollar per peak watt, which is denoted by the symbol dollar per peak watt, where this P stands for peak. Or oftentimes you'll also see this another term, which is dollar per watt DC. So what I want to do in this video is to explain a little bit what do these different terms means, and why do you need this unit? Why do you need this unit to talk about solar panels? So it's not just the newspaper or the journalist. If you look at the companies which sell these solar modules, they also report the prices. So they'll report this ASP, which stands for average selling point, also in this unit, which is dollar per watt. So and they often plot this what is called as a learning curve, which shows how this dollar per watt number has essentially come down over the years as you have increased your production capacity. So this dollar per watt number has fallen down, and currently for these solar modules, this number is somewhere close to 70 to 80 cents per watt, or in fact it's less than a dollar. So it's 70 to 80 cents per watt, and this is a target that is set by the Sunshot program, and they want to bring this the Sunshot program, sponsored by the Department of Energy. They want to bring this cost down to 50 cents per watt. And keep in mind that these numbers, which are less than dollar for dollar per watt in the current prices, they are for modules. They are not for the total system cost. And but people do report the total system cost in the same matrix as well. So they'll report the total system price in dollar per peak watt or dollar per watt. And you see that even though the module price has fallen, or it has reached very close to $1 per watt, the total system cost, or the total cost of price of the system, it still is a few times higher as compared to this module price. So the current price for a residential install in 2011, for example, is close to $6 per watt. So I've quoted all these numbers in dollars per watt, but a question that I wanted to answer in this video is, what is this dollar per watt, or what is this dollar per peak watt? So what this dollar per watt stands for, it's essentially dollar per watt. It's essentially, as the name indicates, so it's the amount of money you spend. So amount of money you spend divided by the watt. That is the watt produced by this by the money spent on the panel. So this is the money you spent on your solar installation. So this dollar per watt is essentially this total dollar spent divided by the number of watts produced by this system at peak power. And this peak power is essentially a term that we need to look into. I need to define for you. So this peak power, essentially, it corresponds to solar irradiance of 1,000 watt per meter square. And this number is not just chosen arbitrarily. The reason why we choose the peak power as 1,000 watt per meter square is that it corresponds very well to what you obtain on a on a sunny day at noontime. So if we previously we talked about these different spectrums, so if you remember this AM 1.5 spectrum, it has a power intensity of approximately 1000 watt per meter square. Exactly, it had around 930 watt per meter square, and this corresponds to essentially a latitude of approximately 48 degree. Say let's say if you are in SF Bay Area, which has a latitude of approximately 37 degree, and if the sun is shining directly overhead, this power that would be incoming would be approximately equal to that 1000 watt per meter square. So this wattage of this system is often reported at this peak power, and it's no accident that we take this peak power to be 1000 watt per meter square, which is very representative of what you get at the peak intensity. So now that we understand this dollar per peak watt, why do we need this unit? Because we don't pay for electricity in dollar per watt, we pay for it in cents per kilowatt hour. So why do we need this dollar per watt unit? So the reason why we need this dollar per watt unit is to compare different technologies. And let me illustrate with an example over here. So let's say I have this panel A, and I can say, let's say this is made up of crystalline silicon. And I also have this other panel which uses a different technology, so it uses a thin film technology. And this panel A, it costs me $200 per meter square. So every meter square of this panel made using this crystalline si silicon technology costs me $200 per meter square. And it has an efficiency of 20%. So what is the dollar per watt number for this panel? So if I buy, let's say, 1 meter square of this panel, so it will cost me $200. And how many watts will this produce at the peak intensity? So at my peak intensity, I have 1000 watt per meter square, and this has a energy conversion efficiency of 20%. So I'll multiply that by 0.2. So this costs me $200, and it produces 200 watt of power at peak intensity. So the dollar per watt number for this panel A is essentially $1 per watt. Now I want to compare, what if I instead spend my money on panel B and buy this panel with the thin film technology. So I need a common metric for comparing these two technology, and as I'll illustrate now, is that this dollar per watt, it serves as a common metric to compare these different technologies, or compare these panels made of these different technologies. So now what is the dollar per watt number for this panel B? So my panel B, if I buy 1 meter square of panel B, it will cost me $80. And how much electricity will it produce? So I have the same peak intensity, which is 1000 watt per meter square, but in this case I have a conversion efficiency of only 10%. So I'll multiply this by 0.1. So I'm spending $80, and I'm getting 100 watt of power at peak intensity. So the dollar per watt number for this panel B is equal to 80 cents per watt. So this is a common metric where I can compare this two different panels, and I can compare the dollar per watt number for them. But keep in mind, I've calculated this number only for the cost of panel over here. And clearly, looking at just the cost, just the module price, or just the panel price, it looks like the panel B is, which is using this thin film technology, is actually looking quite good because it has a less dollar per watt number. But these things can quickly change if you consider the whole system cost. So I'm illustrating that with this example over here. So I've been given this problem statement that says, okay, you have still have these two options, this panel A option, which is made up of crystalline silicon, and panel B option, which is made up of a thin film technology. And what the system requirement is that you want to generate 4 kilowatt of energy at peak power. So you want the system size to be this. And then I've been also given that, you can buy the module as you like, but there will be an installation cost for installing these modules, and that installation cost is $400 per meter square. So now let's see, how does the dollar per watt number compare for again these two technologies? So if I'm using this panel A with the crystalline silicon technology, what is the area required to generate this much of peak power? So I know that if I take 1 meter square of this panel, it will generate 1000 watt multiplied by the efficiency, or it will generate around 200 watt at peak intensity. Now, if I want a peak intensity at peak intensity, if I want a wattage of 4 kilowatt or 4000 watt, then the area which I need is essentially 20 meters square. So now, what is the dollar per watt number for this panel A kind of technology? So the total dollars that I'll spend for 20 meter square of this panel A would be 20 into the price per meter square. So that is 20 into 200. And then for installing 20 meter square of this panel, I'll pay the installation cost of $400 per meter square. So the amount due to that is 400 per meter square into 20 meter square. So that's the dollar spent over here. And what is the wattage I'm getting at peak intensity? So the wattage I'm getting at peak intensity is 4000 watt. So this is a dollar, this is a watt. So you can cancel out all these three zeros over here. And what I get on the numerator is 4 plus 8 divided by 4. So this gives me a value of $3 per watt for the total system price. Now let's do the same exercise for panel B. So now if I have 1 meter square of panel B, it will generate me 1000 watt per meter square into the area, which is 1 meter square. And then the efficiency, which is 0.1. So this will give me 100 watt for 1 meter square of my panel B. So again, if I want a total capacity of 4000 watt at peak intensity, then the area required essentially is 40 meters square. So now what is the total dollars that I spent? So the total dollars that I spent is essentially $80 into this total area. So 80 into 40, plus I'll have to install this 40 meter square of panel. So the cost for that is 40 meter square into $400 per meter square. And again, the total power that I'm generating at peak intensity, it's the same, it's 4000 watt. So I can cancel two zeros over here. So I get 8 times 4, which is 32, plus 40 times, or 4 times 40, which is 160, and divided by 40. So this is 160 plus 32 is 192 divided by 40. And so I can divide this by 2. This gives me 96 by 20, which is the same as 48 by 10. So this gives me actually a dollar per watt number of $4.8 per watt. So if I compare this with the previous calculation where I was just looking at the dollar per watt number for the panel, so panel B was looking better. But now if I'm looking at the system cost where I have to include the installation cost, so what I've realized is that if I use a less efficient panel, I use a much larger area. So I have a much larger installation cost, and that is driving the system price of panel B quite high. But the higher efficiency panel, it's actually looking better in terms of system cost. But nonetheless, I hope you have realized that how this dollar per watt is essentially a common matrix which can be used to compare these panels made of different technology.